Hey everybody, I'm JJ, you're watching Reality Survival, and I got COVID, again, that kind of sucks, but no big deal, my wife's not feeling real great. I feel like I got a cold, head cold, whatever the case may be, but I just wanted to give you guys a real quick tour around the monstrosity of a chicken tractor. It's 8x4, it's not very large. If I was going to do it again, I'd do it 8x6 or 8x8 for that matter. And I don't know if I would build it this heavy duty or not, cause it's pretty heavy duty. still not sure exactly what I'm going to do to keep all the predators out around the base. I'm just going to put this in here to show you I can fit it. What I've got going right now is the tires are about an inch and a half off the ground. It raises the frame about an inch and a half off the ground. So I got these little pieces right here. They're down about 3/4 of an inch. So I can just slide that, along the grass. It shouldn't be that difficult. On the back side, I didn't do that because it would make it a lot harder to push that way. So I think what I'm going to do is just take an 18 inch piece of that hardware cloth and strap a 2x2 to the back of it and just let it hang down. And that way it hangs down like this. So I guess I'm not done. I'm just realizing this as I'm telling you that. I still need to put that on there. So I'll leave that like that. And then on the front, I might just leave it that way. I might just leave it right where it's like it is and see if I have any issues. Because once it's sitting in the grass, I would take it out there, but it's raining right now. And so, I don't want to pull it out there, but when you take it in the grass, you know, there's really only like, there ain't a whole lot of space in there. I know a fox could dig to get under, or a raccoon or whatever, I guess, but I don't know. I'm unconvinced as to whether or not I need to do anything to address these. I may do the same thing and put a skirt out here in the front, and then just have it where, when the door is closed, excuse me, just have some kind of a bungee or something that I could, bring it up and hang it out of the way or something. Pardon me. All right, so this is where the water goes. The waterer, I've got some buckets, little nipples coming. I got something in my throat. And then I'll have a feed bucket over there too. There's enough room to get both of them in there. And then we got a little ramp for them to walk up. Since they don't have a real wide wingspan here, that way they can get up and down. They got a couple extra roost bars, and then we got a nesting box right here by the door, so we can just grab the eggs from right in there. I'm gonna need to put something above this at an angle to keep the chickens off of the top of it, because they'll get up there and try to roost on it and crap on it and everything, so I need to do that too. So anyway, she is, I guess, 90% done, not 100%. With the wheels, this is what I did. when you only put a bolt on one side, they'll get all tilted and roll weird. So I just kind of built this little bridge out of 2x4s. That way it's got support on each side. If I have any problem, those are just put in with number 3-inch screws. If I have any issues with that, I'll get some long carriage bolts and just, tighten up some carriage bolts through there, through the center. But it seems to be holding pretty good. These are flat-free tires, so hopefully they won't break down. But I think it'll work. I think it'll work for the time being. I know it costs enough money. Having to buy all this stuff new was not cheap at all. Anyway, that is that. I don't know what else you would want to see. I don't think this is the best design, but I am of the opinion that if you're going to do something, do it right and do it once and not have to do it again. I don't want to have to mess with it again, because whenever I do projects for a second time, I don't have the same enthusiasm that I do the first time. And so I wanted it to be something that would last, that we could have here. We could use it as a temporary coop and run for when we're building the shop, probably next year. And then, so I can put the chickens in here and let them run around the yard, or, push them around. And it rolls real, real easy. I need to figure out some sort of handle too. now that I'm grabbing it. But as you can see it, it rolls pretty easy. So, and I took it out into the shop or out into the grass and rolled it and it did fine in the grass too. So it'll be a little harder with those little skirts on the side, but, yeah. And then I did those little skirts. You can't see that. Hang on. I did the little skirts inside the wheels as well. So the sides are pretty good. I mean, I don't think anything's going to get up underneath there from the sides. From the front or the back, maybe. Maybe. That's just kind of an extra on the door closer. Something could potentially get in there, up underneath there. I don't think we have any minks and weasels here. As far as I know, they could definitely get in if we do. But anywho, that's pretty much it. Oh, I forgot to screw that board in. I guess I need to do that. All right, so I got a few things left, but you get the idea. Renaissance Marine was saying he was wanting to see what it came out like, so I just figured I'd give you guys a quick update video just for my buddy. If you guys aren't subscribed to his channel, then you should go over there and subscribe. All right, guys, that's pretty much it. Don't forget to live 6 P's. Proper prior preparation prevents poor performance. Stay safe.